Good morning, dear students. In the previous session, we had seen that the iteration using a while loop and for loop, and we have executed some codes. So in this session, we are going to immediately start the chapter 2 because we are already far behind the syllabus. So functions and scoping. Let me understand the two words functions and scoping first. Function, already you know that it is a part of a code which we are going to use, reusable code on the curriculum, on the small part of the code on the curriculum. If the code is divided, if the code is breaked in the small parts, that is possible from the function itself. So earlier functions alone you kaltidu, C and C++, Java, agli. Is my voice is audible to you? Raise your hands. Is my voice is audible to you? Raise your hand. Yes. Okay. So as it is, if we write a straight line code, if we write a straightforward code using even though using the branching function, we are going to write a program. So it may be a lengthier. Some part of the code is going to be lengthier. So what we are going to do is we are going to break down the code into the parts. Those parts are known as a those blocks on the keyboard. Now those blocks are known as a functions. They are reusable codes. Again and again we can use. Again and again we can call. So it is a function. It is called as a function. Definition of the function. As you know that in the C++, Java. So we are not going to see as much as the definition, but we know that it is a part of a code. It is a block of a code which we are going to use a reusable for a reusable and again and again calling purpose. If we necessary, if that part is necessary to twice, we are going to call it twice. So hange Python kuda nu nam function nange ella tarada concept of the programming language ik support maduvanga Python igunu Python olagade nu functions anta ide. Okay, Python functions anta bandaga so neevu illa artha madkobekagittu. We know that functions. We know about the definition of the functions. So as we discussed, that is a reusable code. So ಒಂದಷ್ಟು ಲೆಂದಿಯರ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ ಆದಾಗ ಅದನ್ನ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ಡೌನ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ನಾವು ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋತೀವಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಏನೇನ್ ಬರ್ತಾವ, ವಾಟ್ ಹೌ ಟು ಡಿಫೈನ್ ಅ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಪೈಥಾನ್, ಹೌ ಟು ಡಿಫೈನ್ ಅ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಪೈಥಾನ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೌ ಟು ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಅ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಪೈಥಾನ್ ಅಂತ ಬಂದಾಗ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಲರ್ನ್ ದಟ್ ಒನ್. ವಿ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಲರ್ನ್ function here, how to write the function, because you already know that what is a function. It is unnecessary to discuss the points one again. There is actual parameter, there is a formal parameter. What is actual parameter, what is a formal parameter, that we'll discuss again and again in the programs. Okay, but it is not mandatory to discuss all the things because you already in the final year you know what the functions. But still, functions on the one like a block of code which are going to use for reusable purpose. Okay, so again, agatha antandre function ana heng baribeku, how to write a function in Python. So how to write anta bandaga question mark anta bantu andre we are going to have a syntax first. We are going to have the syntax, functions and scoping. It is our topic. Functions in the sense normal functions we are going to write. Scoping in the sense the life of the function. The life of the function scope. Elli varuku aa function irutti. Appi code execute aagu varuku elli varuku adra scope irutti. Scope andre telidu andukonni. Ee point indre ee point tana adra life anta helthiru. Ee point certain starting point to ending point ondu scope ada life ada. Aa life end aayitu antandre that scope is over. That scope is going to be over. So that will be last part of our session. First we are going to learn functions. So how to write functions in Python. How to write functions. So for this we are having the syntax. We already know that we already used the some functions in Python. Now already use ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ functions ಅನ್ನು. So ಯಾವ functions ಅನ್ನು use ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ? We used print. It is a built-in function. We used input, which is built-in functions. ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ನಾವು built-in functions. There are again here comes the point. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ತರದ functions ಅದಾವ. ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ತರದ functions ಇದೆ. One is built-in function, another one is user-defined function. Yes, of course, the Python is going to support for the two categories. So here we are going to just all the functions by passing the parameter. Built-in function ಗೆ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಮೀಟರ್ ನ ಪಾಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬರ್ತೀವಿ. ಬಟ್ ದಿ ಸಿಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಟು ರೈಟ್ ದ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್, ಯೂಸರ್ ಡಿಫೈನ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಅನ್ನ ಬರೀತಕ್ಕಂತ ಸಿಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಬಿಲ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಇರ್ತದೆ, ಬಿಲ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಇನ್ ಪೈಥಾನ್. ದಿಸ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ರೈಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ರೈಟ್ ದ ಸಿಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್, ರೈಟ್ ದ ಸಿಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಯೂಸ್ before writing the function name, before the function name we have to use def. def, that refers, it is a reserve word in a Python. Def is a reserve word in a Python that tells to the interpreter here user is going to define a function. The def is a reserve word that is going to tell the interpreter when it comes to this point. Def in the sense, yes interpreter, here the user is going to define a function. After def, what will be the thing? Of course the name of the function. The name of the function, that is, you can write name of the function, or else we can write like this, function name. Yes, there are rules. When def, this refers as a defining the function name. User is going to define function here. Function name. For writing the function name, you need to follow some rules and regulations. Yes, of course, you can use the underscore while writing the function name, but don't give the space like this. For example, I'm defining addition number as a function, addition of number as a function. Yes, this is a valid name for the function. There is no space. Can it be valid, sir? Addition of number. Yes, it is also valid because it is a underscore. It is underscore. Next, addition of num. Can it be valid, sir? No, because there is a space. Don't leave the space while writing the function name. Yes, of course, underscore is valid, and there is no space in the sense. It is also a valid one. So this is a small rule you need to remember while declaring the function. So here in the bracket, formal parameters. Interpreter will understand, yes, if def is found, here user is defining his function. I will give the function name and formal parameter. Let us understand what is the formal parameter and what is the actual parameter. If I am having a function called adding purpose function in Tundra, if I pass a comma b, which are not actual values, which are not actual values. What do you mean by the actual values, sir? Here I am passing the variables. A and B are the variables. These variables containing some values. Understand? Concentrate here. Here I am passing the A and B, which are not the values. Which are not values. Yes, I am going to write a colon. Lastly, I am going to write a colon. Okay. A comma B are the function parameters, formal parameters. A is a variable, B is a variable, which are holding some values. We are not passing the actual values which are present in A and B. We are passing the formal parameters. Okay, if A is equal to 20, B is equal to 30. So, when you pass the value as A, object, which object is present here? 20 is the object I am formally sending. So, here 30. Here 30 is going to be. So, if I pass like this, add 20, 30. Directly I am passing the value in the sense, those are called as actual values, that is actual parameters. This is what the difference between a formal parameters and actual parameters, as you know in the previous programming languages. So, we are passing the values by formal parameters, that is a variables I am passing here. Here I am passing a actual values. Adhe values anna kalasthikirthivi, but formal parameters andre adara representative anna kalasthikirthivi. See here, what do you mean by this one, sir? If someone goes instead of us, namma moolaka hogu badle bere yaro moolaka nimage maahiti bantu antandre, that is a formal anna karithivi. Directly we are not entering. Directly we are not entering. If directly we are entering into the that situation, a situation anna ig henga agirthadu antandre some situation olagade na involve aagi parangilla nimma nimma friends madhyane na solve madisthike prayatnavanna padthivi. So adakna formal anta karithivi. Nodu idu hing ada situation na avaru ibbarigu helu ninu ee tara maadabadu, that is a one kind of a formal. If I entered and I am going to talk in front of you, it is your problem, it is your problem, it is your problem. That is, if I am involving, that is actual. If I am passing through it some variables, that is a formula. Okay. After this, don't forget to put a colon in front of the here. Don't forget to put a colon here. So after that, what will be the thing? That after it, here I am going to write block of function. Block of function. What is the DEF here? DEF is reserve word. Reserve word for defining the function. For defining the function. Next, what is the function name? The name given to function. The name given to function by user. What is the formal parameter? Passing the objects through its variables, it's called as a formal parameters. Have we used any built-in functions previous? Yes, we have used print input. Sir, is there any other built-in functions? Yes, as we see in the strings, slice is a built-in function, indexing is a built-in function related to those strings. Length is a built-in function related to the strings. Have you clear with the functions topic? Have you clear with the general functions topic? Before going to the program, have you clear with the concept, my dears? Raise your hands. if you clear. Raise your hand if you clear. Raise your hand if it is clear. Well, let me start a program here. Program that illustrate function. Program that illustrate function. This is your first program. So I'll write a syntax here before starting the program that I can refer the syntax. DEF function name. Formal parameters. Colon here. Block of function. So, which kind of a program we are going to write here is that I am going to take our two formal parameters, that it may be a comma b. A and B as a formal parameters. According to it, I am going to pass it right as it is. Def DEF. Function name I am going to give as max value. That is, I am finding the maximum of A and B. That I am going to find out the maximum value of A comma B. That I am going to pass. That I am going to pass here A comma B. Colon. So, as I rule, according to the rule, I am defining the function. Yes, DEF max val, there is a no space, there is an underscore, then it is a value. If there is underscore, there is no problem. Define max value A comma B, that is colon. So I will check the condition. If A is greater than B. If A is greater than B, which value I have to return? That is, which value I have to print? Print A. Else, that I need to write a colon again. Else print B. In the prompt, that is in the cell, I need to call this function. That is, how you are going to call the function here? That is calling the function. Normally programming language ಒಳಗಡೆ ಹೆಂಗ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ರಿ ಅದೇ ರೀತಿನೇ ಕಾಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕಾಲ್ ವಿದಿನ್ ದ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್. ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎಲ್ಸ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ರೈಟ್ ದ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ 3,2. ಸಿ ಎಲ್ ದ ಇಂಟರ್ಪ್ರಿಟರ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್. He is going to pass 3,2. These will be the actual values. These will be the actual parameters. That means going to record as a formal in definition of the function. This is a calling the function. This is the calling the function here. What we are doing here? Max val function is called here. The max val function is called. This is a called function. This is a calling function. ಯಾರಿಗ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಮಾಡಕತ್ತಿವಲ್ಲ ಅವ್ರು ಕಾಲಿಂಗ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗ್ತಾರೆ. ಯಾರು ಕಾಲ್ ಮಾಡಲ್ಲ ಅವರು ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗ್ತಾರೆ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್. 3,2
the 3 is going to be assigned for A and 2 is going to be assigned for B. Here comes the A value 3 and B value 2. It will be passed here. 3 is greater than 2. What will be the output? The output will be A. That is 3. If I am going to pass like this, 4, 6, what will be the output? The output will be the 6. The output will be the 6.
Have you clear with this? Have you clear with this? Raise your hand. Have you clear with this? Raise your hand. Well, we'll execute this one by sharing the screen. Let me understand what is the code first. Okay, wait for 2 seconds. I'm going to share the screen. Wait for the 2 seconds. I'm going to share the screen. I'll pause the. So now I'm going to share the screen here. That is the editor where I'm going to write a program. The editor where I'm going to write a program here. One second. Well, here I have not saved any program name here. I'm not at any saved program here. So I'm going to save it as Control H. Is prompt is visible to you now? Is prompt is visible to you? Raise your hand. What I am doing that is visible to you? Raise your hand. My dear students, what I am doing that is visible to you now? Yes. So I will save it as first function program. First, we'll write so many function programs here. For first function programs. First function program. Save it. See here. I have saved as first function program. So let me declare directly. How to declare a program function first? First is keyword def I'm going to use. The next one is function name. What I need to give? Max val. Under the bracket, inside the bracket, I need to pass two formal parameters, a comma b. I'm going to pass it. Next, what it is? It will take the indentation itself. If we put the colon, it will take an indentation. No worries to how to indent, sir. Tab press modbeka space. No, it will take. Okay. Next, what is my thing? If a is greater than b, colon. Enter. Print the value of A plus is greater. Just I added some extra strings here. That is, it is double quote is a string one. This double quote is string two. We are going to concatenate these two things with A. The same thing happen with the second one. If there is a no semicolon, it will accept. Okay. I'll pass else colon. Here I'm going to take it as B. B is a greater one. Control S. I can call in the command prompt, but I'm going to show it in once again here itself. Here I'm going to call. See here, my cursor is below the D, in the sense I'm out of the scope of the function. That I'm going to call here, max val 4, 6 here. That is control. Yes, I'm going to run the program. Now I will stop the screen. I'll run the module. I'm going to run the module. Run module. There I got a. There I got a error. Error. One error. Sikkad nanage enantu error ada antandra. I'll share that error now. I'll share that error. Where it is? Yes, here it is. See this one. See this one. Can code is visible in the behind the screen? Code is visible. Code is visible. Yes. What it is telling? What it is telling? Can only concat string, not int. See here, what happening? A is holding the object or object as 4. 4 is the integer. We cannot concatenate the integer here. We cannot concatenate the integer. Only strings can be concatenated. Okay. What I need to do now here? What I need to do here is code is visible now. Is code is visible now? Raise your hand. Yes. I'm going to write it as str of a. Str of a. Here, str of b. Str of b. Okay. Control yes. Once again, I'm going to run the module. What I modified that is visible to you. What I modified that is visible to you. Raise your hand. What I modified that is visible to you, raise your hand. Nahi modify madini adu kaanlikattu nimage. Here I am modified, that is visible. Raise your hand. Okay, I modified the strings. Okay, I will run the module now. I'll run the module. Is output is visible? Is output is visible? Raise your hand. Is output is visible? Raise your hand. Yes. The value of b is 6. The value of b is 6. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to remove this line. I'm going to remove this line. Control yes. I'm going to remove this line. Control yes. We'll see. We will see. Can I call directly in the prompt? We'll see, can I call it in prompt? So what I given the name as max val, max. So let me call, there is no time, max val of 10, 2. The value of is, I can call in the cell, I can call the function in the cell, that is a command prompt, even though I can call it as in a function. Have you clear with this? Have you clear with the today's topic, calling the function and defining the function? Okay, I need to give the same value. Okay, okay. I am going to give the same value as it is 4, 3, I think so. Max value. Max value 4, 2. I have given, I think so. I am not remembering it. So 4 is a greater. 4 is a greater. 4 is greater. Have you clear with it? Have you clear with it?